Okay, now this is almost dry and it hasn't sufficiently lightened to suit me, so I know I'm going to have to do something to correct these pink branches here and pull them forward. More likely than not, I'll come in with white gouache paint mixed with a little pink and dot those in. But I'm going to save that for later and keep working on getting the white off of the paper right now. Getting everything at least with some sort of paint on it. Now this tree trunk is kind of a golden brown and there's a lot of texture on it. It's more sunstruck at the bottom side. And as it comes up to the top, it's actually very dark. So I want to mix a brownish color. Now to get a nice brown, I can mix red and green. So it's which red and which green, and that's a good question. Let's just try something here. I'm going to try brown matter. An olive green. Let's see how that looks. That's pretty good. That's brown matter plus olive green. Right about here is where it starts to darken, so I'm going to add some Payne's Gray into my mix. Still looks a little bit greenish. I'm going to add add some alizarin crimson in with that. That's better. Just dry brushing to create texture on the light struck side. I want it both darker yet, so I'm going to add more Payne's Gray And more alizarin, crimson. Now there's some mossy looking stuff on the sides and the tops. I'm going to put that with olive green. It's along the side here. I'm going to pick up my original tree color and come back on this edge. Coming back to the olive green, and I'm going to put some of that, excuse me, on this entire side. And then I need to come back in with some dark texture marks. And I'm going to add some twigs. Except I want them lighter. Trying to create more texture on the bark. I'm just tapping my brush with this darker color. Might just as well put the branches in up here too. And I'm mixing olive green and brown matter to get the brown color. Now the thing you want to be careful about here is adding enough water to your paint so that it will flow smoothly, but then also staying right up on the tip of your brush. The more pressure you apply on the brush, the thicker your line is going to be. And the fastest way to ruin a tree is to start putting in lines that are so thick they just don't look natural. And how do I know that? Because I've done it so many times. So you really have to, you have to realize less is more here. We don't want to put every single branch and twig and everything else. That's too much detail. We just want it to be believable that it's a tree. So it needs to have a few branches, but nothing exotic. Remember, the further you get away from the main branches, they get thinner and thinner as they go out. We need some branches in this tree. and there's a lot of weathered wood here on this fence or wall or whatever it is, and I'm going to dry brush that. I need to lighten this up. I didn't come far enough with my dark, so I need to get that in. There's a hedge of some sort here with greenery coming up the tree. Dropping some yellow in there. Now I want a nice bright lime green color for back here on this. It's not quite green enough. This very sunstruck area of grass. There's more yellow down first. And then come on top of it with the green. There's also a bush over here, which I've completely ignored, so I have to get that in. Of course, we have to have a cast shadow under it so it sits down. We want cast shadows under these tree trunks, which I see kind of got wiped out with my coloring in the fence. I'm going to have to go back and reinforce that. That's too green. I think this is dry enough. We could put our bicycler in. Now we have to keep him simple. I'm going to come back and do more work on these trees. There's bushes, some kind of a shrub here. Well, somehow I failed to get grass underneath that. So let's get that in there. Oh, I forgot these tree trunks here. a little bit darker brown to create some texture on these tree trunks. Now I think we can get some darker texture marks on this tree trunk. Just some dry brushing here. I want to be able to see more texture on this trunk than on these, because this one's closer to me. Okay, now I think I can start the bicycler. And what I was saying is we have to keep him simple. Much of it is dark. He's an older gentleman with white hair, and he's wearing a baseball cap. So I'm going to start with Payne's Gray, and I'm going to put some brown matter with that. And some shadow green. Most of the whole bicycle and legs and pants and everything are just various values of a dark color. You can't see a lot of detail. I'm going to come down under his shirt here. I'm placing the darkest areas that I see first. And now I'm going to add some water to that so that it's not as dark. Okay, I'm going to let that dry before I do anything more, because otherwise the colors are all going to merge. So let's start up on his head. He's got a dark cap on. And then there's stripes in his shirt. Got a little bit dark. It's supposed to be his arms. And there's just a bit of a rose color in his shirt as one of the stripes. His back is sunstruck. I'm going to try to scrub out a little bit of this color up here on his shoulders. Needed to be lighter up here. Well, I'm definitely going to have to fix that shirt now with white when I fix the tree. It's not distinct enough. It doesn't have enough detail to convince you that that's a bicycle rider. It doesn't convince me. So it needs work. All right, let's see what we can do here. Okay, I'm going to go get my white gouache paint and see what we can do as the final fix and be done with this. Okay, I'm using Winsor & Newton Designer's Gouache in Permanent White. I want to highlight the white stripes in his shirt and the sun striking his shoulders. It is quite weak. I did add water to it though, so we'll see what that does and then come back if we need to with that. And now I'm going to mix some of that white with a touch of bright rose to create a light pink color. It seems somewhat light, but we'll see what happens as it dries. I would like to add some permanent rose. The color seems too lavender-like. It really needs to be more pink. I don't know, I'm still not pleased with this. I think I'm going to have to come in here with little spots of dark to show depth. But while that's drying, let me work on this tree over here, which is somewhat underdeveloped. I'm going to add more white and some of the cad yellow light which makes it a softer, warmer pink color. Okay, while those dry, I'm going to come back to the bicycler. I need to get a better flesh tone color. I'm going to mix Queen Gold with Permanent Rose. And add just a slight bit of green from my palette. Let's see if this gets any better. No, that's too dark. Adding water. Still, it's too dark. I'm gonna add some transparent yellow to it. Adding some of the white gouache. The outside edge of his arm is struck by the sun, and that's too dark. Going back to just the white gouache, excuse me, I'm going to strengthen these white stripes in his shirt. Sunstruck shoulder. Give him a little bit more of a red reflector light on his fender, although that's too bold. And I think I want to see some of that grass in the distance ahead of him, in between his arm and his body. Ooh, that's bright. Okay. I think I need to add some darker olive green in here to give foliage on the front side of those branches. Right now that doesn't look correct. So I'm going to go to olive green. Careful. And tap. That seems a bit strong. I'm going to water that down a little bit. And I'm just going to soften the edges. That's better for that. And I could have some darker darks in this tree as well. And for that, I'm going to use shadow green. I want it just to be a soft diffusion of the color. I don't want it harsh. Can actually use a separate brush to drop in some water and soften the edges so I don't have to keep rinsing the color out of my brush. Okay, this is dry now, so I'm going to come back in here and try once more to redefine these. I think what I'm missing here still is I can see yellow as if there was a yellow tree behind us. So I'm going to take a little of the transparent yellow and mix it with the white gouache and see if I can get some of that in here. It's this transition from the dark shadow to the pink branches that I do not like. This has perhaps been a little bit more difficult than I thought it was going to be to get the look of this tree. But this is how we learn. You have to just experiment and see what you get. Okay, sorry for that abrupt cut off. My phone ran out of space and just cut me right off from taping anything more. So I just want to touch you up to what I did after that stopped. I put some more pink over in this tree. I added some green branches over here. And I took just a full strength of the white gouache and put it down where I want branches to come forward. I missed something here. And now I'm going to go over that with the pink. And hopefully it's going to look more realistic. Let's see what happens. A little bit strong. Okay, I think that kind of did the trick. I'm going to put just a little bit darker permanent rose. And there's all kinds of thin, lanky, twisty branches within the tree, which I need a light brown, kind of like the road for. That's a little bit too light. Okay, let's just take a minute here to evaluate what we've got and see if we're finished. I think I intended to come back over here with some more of the emerald green, and I never did that. Could cover up some of that. This is really dense foliage over here. Okay, that's better. Be a slight bit more of a green color back here. And that shadow could be darker. It actually comes right across the road. There's a little bit of greenery that I missed in here. It's not real apparent, but it's there. So I'm using olive green. Same with back here. Just trying to get some of that white. The white of the paper there is a little bit distracting because that's a more shadowed area. I'm still not happy with this tree, but I don't think that if I keep messing with it, it's going to get any better. And so lesson learned for me, I need to figure out a better way to tackle a tree like this, that you can see the dark behind it, but the light branches are in front of it. That was a challenge. I'm not seeing anything else that displeases me. So I think I'm going to call this done and get it signed. And I thank you so much for watching and hope that you learned something from me and enjoyed the video. Happy painting to you, and I'll see you on the next one. Thank you.